Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. Wanted to spend just a moment and talk a little bit about MIL-STD-461. What is MIL-STD-461? Why is it important to our customers? That's really the question of the day. And what we do here is we try to isolate the amount of emissions that come from the equipment that we produce, and we also try to shield the equipment from susceptibility of those emissions. So what MIL-STD-461 does is it tries to isolate the victims from the offenders in terms of radiated emissions and susceptibility. So what that means is that the standard is essentially split up into four sections. There is conducted emissions, and there are three conducted emission tests that you can perform on units. So that's essentially power lines and antenna lines that come into the box. Are you conducting nasty signals into the box via those lines? And then there's conducted susceptibility. Are you susceptible to radiation, electromagnetic radiation, when those power lines or those antenna lines are exposed to that kind of a field? So that's conducted susceptibility. And there are actually nine different levels of conducted susceptibility. In terms of radiated emissions, there are three different categories of radiated emissions. And radiated emissions are what's coming off of the unit, more of a electromagnetic spectrum. So radiated emissions are something that we're very careful about how we construct the box so that we don't have those issues. Radiated susceptibility has three tests also, and those are essentially magnetic field and electrical field. So 461 tries to divide that magnetic and electrical spectrum and antennas and power lines and essentially transients, and tries to isolate the box that you're building from the environment and the environment from the box. And so what it does is it provides a bar, if you will, for testing. If you look at table 5 in 461, it's on page, for the revision F, I think it's on page 26. And you can kind of figure out what things are applicable, whether you're on a surface ship or a submarine, or whether you're in the aircraft or a ground mobile, ground navy, or ground army, that kind of application. The levels are different depending on what application that your end product is in. And so that's a kind of a brief digest of what's going on in 461. There are other specifications out there that also cover that electromagnetic field, specs like IEC 6100-4-3, there's DO 160. All of these things are relative to what's coming out of the box in terms of emissions and what's getting into the box in terms of emission. And that, in a nutshell, is MIL-STD-461. Thanks.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.